I am Johnny Wiberg and I work as an engineer at Expander System Sweden. This video will guide you through how to measure a pivot and how to fill in the dimension sheet. You're actually just a few measurements away from specifying your first pivot. When measuring a pivot, you need a caliper, measuring tape, or a steel ruler. We start from the top of the dimension sheet. Machine make and model is normally clearly written on the machine. Machine make and model can also be found on the machine identification plate. The machine model year and serial number can also be found here. Pin location on the machine can be described in words, but preferably by using figures from Expander's principal sketches. The original pin article number or part number is not normally written on the original pin itself, but might be found on the original package. The original pin diameter can be measured in three ways. First, the diameter could be measured on a dismounted axle. Second, it could be measured on the end of the pin. Third, it could be measured between the lugs. This method is possible only if the gap is not totally filled up with shims. There is actually one more trick. If there are several original pins with identical design and measurements of visible parts, it's likely that those pins have the same diameter. Measure the distance between the outside edges of the mounting lugs, measuring accuracy plus minus 1 mm. Measure the width of each mounting lug, measuring accuracy plus minus 1 mm. Fill in the original diameters of the holes of the mounting lugs, bushings removed if applicable. If the holes are more than 1.5 mm worn, measure the maximum and minimum diameters of the worn holes, measuring accuracy plus minus 0.2 mm. By moving the pivot back and forth, the play between axle and lug can be estimated even with the pin mounted. Lug diameters can be stated based on this or other estimations. To get the right Expander system for the application, it is vital to state the proper information about obstacles. No obstacle implies free space of at least 100 mm or 4 inch outside each lug, no matter how the pivot moves in operation. Moving obstacle means that either the obstacle or the pivot itself can be moved to get clearance for mounting and torquing of the Expander system. A fixed obstacle can't be removed or is very hard to remove. The most common hoses are hydraulic hoses. The greasing of the pivot can be done in three different ways. A. External greasing. B. Greasing through pin. One outlet centered between the inner edges of the lugs. Or C. Greasing through pin. Two outlets. If B, indicate from which side the pivot is greased. If C, measure the greasing outlet distance from respective outside edge of mounting lug. Measuring accuracy plus minus 1 mm. Locking rings are not considered being part of the lug. However, correct locking ring information is essential to get the right Expander system for the application. If there is a locking ring on the pivot, the bottom part of the dimension sheet is used to fill in the appropriate information. Indicate on which side the locking ring is situated. Measure locking ring inner diameter, measuring accuracy plus minus half millimeter. Measure locking ring outer diameter, measuring accuracy plus minus 1 millimeter. Measure locking ring width, measuring accuracy plus minus 1 millimeter. That's it! So, what's next? Please forward the pivot dimensions to your local dealer, or expander system, or Nord-Lock group, and we will return with a suggestion of a suitable expander system for your application, as well as a quote. Thank you, and I hope you found this information useful.